it's like Dean Dillon told me one time, Ronnie, they're not all home runs. But I will tell you this, if you don't step up to the plate and swing, you're never going to have a chance.
This is Live at the Hall from the Country Music Hall of Fame and Museum. This week, hit songwriter Ronnie Bowman performs and shares stories for a live audience in the museum's Ford Theater.
Since Chris Stapleton's exhibit is up now, I'm going to sing y'all the first song we ever wrote, if that's okay. Anyway. Couldn't wait to turn 16, drive all the boys around. Foot on the gas, hands on the wheel, was all I could think about. A little rust in the bed of that truck and four speed on the floor. $500, it was mine, all mine, and never wanted nothing more. Took Katie Joe down by the river with a $6 bottle of wine. Just a fool trying to play it cool, hoping she'd let me cross the line. And I was praying that she couldn't tell, I'd never been that far before. The first time's a one-time feeling, and I never wanted nothing more. No, I never wanted nothing more. Cause I'm what I am, and I'm what I'm not. Now I'm sure happy with what I got. I live to love and laugh a lot, and that's all I need. My buddies all try to change my mind, but I told them that I thought it through. Katie laughed and my mama cried when they heard me say I do. Her little ring is a little thing, but it's all that I could afford. Now she's mine, all mine, till the day I die. And I never wanted nothing more. No, I never wanted nothing more. Cause I'm what I am, I'm what I'm not. I'm sure happy with what I got. I live to love and laugh a lot, and that's all I need, yeah. Mama, do this verse for you right here. One Sunday I listened to the preacher and I knew he was preaching to me. I couldn't help it, I walked up front and I got down on my knees. And right then and there I swear I changed when I found the Lord. Glory, hallelujah, good God Almighty, I never wanted nothing more. No, I never wanted nothing more. Cause I'm what I am and I'm what I'm not. Now I'm sure happy with what I got. I live to love and laugh a lot, and that's all I need. I never wanted nothing more. Thank you. Anyway, that that was the first song Chris Stapleton and I ever wrote, and I talked to him yesterday, and I'm like, man, why'd you have to sing everything so good? Because now, I mean, how am I going to do it? Because I'm no Chris Stapleton, but you know, God made me Ronnie Bowman, so I'm going to try to do my best for you. Anyway, he laughed, you know. I started writing songs. I started singing when I was 3 years old, and I did it because it pleased my mom and dad, but people would give me quarters, and as far as like the actual writing a song, I love doing that just as much as I love anything. And I remember, and it's because my mama Hazel, she said, "Son, have you ever thought about writing me a song?" And I mean, if you're a good boy and, you know, and you love your mama, and I did, and I still do, that I wanted to make her proud. And so I went, we were sharecropping, and I was living in a trailer, and, well, we were, and I had, like, if you went through the front door, you took a left, and it was the first door on the right, and if you've ever been in one, you know exactly what I'm talking about. And I went back there, and I wrote her a song, and because she loved gospel music, so it was a gospel song, and so at 14, that's what I did. Anyway, I don't know. Can I do some of it? Nah. It was something like this. "We're not alone. He always walks beside us." Keep in mind, this is my first song I ever wrote. "We're not alone. He can and will guide us. We're not alone. He drives away the shadows, I know. And if he comes knocking, I hope that you'll let him in." So, anyway, that was the first song I ever wrote in my life, you know? And it was because of my mama Hazel that I even attempted it. And after that, it sparked this this thing inside me musically. And I remember then I got a call from, I'd played with the Lost and Found, and then I got this call from Tim Austin, and he told me he wanted me to join the band, and I listened to, I think it was their first record that Dan Tominski was on, and I heard them say that, and so I showed up with a notebook, you know, just full of songs, and they were horrible. Anyway, we cut some of them, and anyway, so I'd like to do you one. This one hasn't been recorded yet, but I'm thinking about recording it because I'm thinking about doing an album. Well, I know I'm going to do one, God willing. And it's kind of fun, and it's kind of summerish. It goes something like this. My factory job burning power went up a dollar an hour, so I went and bought you some flowers. Ain't we living the life? The kids are trying to stay cool. They're glad to be out of school. So I blew up their swimming pool. Ain't we living a lie? Now, honey, I know we ain't rolling in dough, but we roll with the punches and we roll with the flow. And when things ain't going like we think they should, we give it all we got. Take the bad with the good. Well, still got this front porch for shade, 'cause this month the bills all got paid. honey, we sure got it made. Ain't we living the life? Like a dog, but ain't we having a ball? Just a living life. Well, honey, I know we ain't rolling in dough, but we roll with the punches and we roll with the flow. And when things ain't going like we think they should, we give it all we got and take the bad with the good. Still got this front porch for shade, 'cause this month the bills all got paid. Honey, we sure got it made. Ain't we living a life? Yeah, we living life.
I think I want to do this one. This is a song that I wrote with Chris, but it's never been recorded. And I've been trying to get him to record it, but he still hasn't.
Whenever I'm broken, honey, you heal me. When I'm in the dark, you are my light. When I get lost, you know right where to find me. When I have my doubts, girl, you make me believe. And it takes a woman, it takes a woman, a woman who sees the best part of me through all that I am. It takes a It takes a woman to be all I can, to feel like a man. It takes a woman. You are my comfort whenever I'm troubled, when I'm alone, you are my friend. You make me high, keep my feet on the ground. Whatever I need, girl, you give it to me. It takes a woman, it takes a woman who sees the best part of me through all that I am. It takes a woman, it takes a woman, be all I can, to feel like a man. It takes a woman.
Well, I always write a song in hopes that anybody will record it. And I wrote that with Jerry Sally and Chris Stapleton. And I mean, I wish that y'all could hear the demo of Chris singing it. I mean, it'll just give you cold chills. I mean, it's so big. But, you know, it's like Dean Dillon told me one time, Ronnie, they're not all home runs. But I will tell you this, if you don't step up to the plate and swing, you're never going to have a chance. So this is a song that I wrote with Chris Stapleton and Barry Bales. And I remember I went there that day and you know, it was another one of those days where I made Garnet mad. And anyway, and so we wrote a song, and I mean, it was all right. You know, it's nothing I'd ever want to sing for you. I mean, unless somebody makes it a big hit, then I will. And anyway, so I needed to go, you know, I'm thinking, okay, we wrote a song, so I just want to go back home because I was feeling kind of lowly, sad, you know, because, I mean, you really don't want to be in an argument or, you know, make your wife feel bad, right? You know, I mean, I don't know how many of you have tried it before, but it don't work out very well. And so, anyway, and they said, so what's up? Why don't we just write another song? And I said, well, I probably need to get home because Garnet's mad at me and I ain't got nobody to blame but me. And they said, they called it. I mean, I didn't catch it. They called it. And they said, that'd make a good country song. And I told them, I'm like, well, why don't y'all write it? Because, I mean, you know, nowadays, and I mean this with all due respect, at the time in my mind, it was like, who's going to cut a country song? And anyway, it turned out the guy that actually cut the country song was Chris Stapleton. And then it was up for Song of the Year at the ACMs. Was it Las Vegas? And so I told, you know, I was not planning on going. I just like, you know, I've been to Las Vegas and I don't want to lose any more money. I really don't gamble. But plus I really don't like to be hot. And so anyway, I was talked into going to Las Vegas, Nevada for the, you know, ACM Awards there. And I was very thankful because I got to meet Nick Jonas and a bunch of other people, which I probably can't remember. And it was the first award that was given for the night, which made me feel good because I don't know if you've ever attended an award show. It's very long. And they want you to stay in your seat. And if you drink a lot of Coca-Cola or water or something, you're going to have to get out of that seat eventually. And anyway, we won that. And so I got to hang out backstage all night and I got to meet all the incredible music stars. And anyway, I mean, I said all that to sing this. She took down a photograph of our wedding day, ripped it down the middle, threw my app away. And I got nobody to blame but me. I got nobody to blame but me. She broke
took all of my fishing rod, put my guns in hog, threw my clothes out in the yard, chained out all the locks, and I got nobody to blame but me. I got nobody to blame but me. I know right where I went wrong. I know just what got her gone. Turned my life into this country song, and I got nobody to blame me. I got nobody to blame but me. Fired up my old hot rod, ran it in the pond, put sugar in my John Deere, I can't even mow my lawn, and I got nobody to blame but me. I got nobody to blame but me. And speaking of guitars, she built her a bonfire with my old six string, took all my good whiskey and poured it down the drain, and I got nobody to blame me. I got nobody to blame but me. I know right where I went wrong. Her gone, turned my life into this country song, and I got nobody to blame me. I got nobody to blame but me. I got nobody to blame but me. Thank you.